energy vibration reading for the Libra and Sun, Moon, and Rising for the month of July. I want to say thank you for being here. Thank you for being back. This is a wonderful, wonderful energy for the month of July. Thank you for likes, shares, and support. Please thumbs up. And I want to say to you, Librans, I am so grateful for your support. Please subscribe. And for a personalized reading, please contact us by the link at the bottom of this video. So, okay, this month of July is the month of the Emperor, and this is you working out karmatic situation with a group of people. Okay, this is wonderful, because then you'll be working out a lot of situation with the groups of people in your life. Okay, so karmatic situation, because each and every person is here to work karma. Okay, it no doesn't matter if you don't create karma, you're working karma. Please like, share these videos and thumbs up. Remember to listen to the quarter readings, because they're already up, to see what's going to happen. An extra message from the month of July, and June, July, August, and September. Okay, you guys have the energy of the Tower. Now, the energy of the Tower is a cleansing, is an healing that is coming in for you guys. The energy of the Tower is a cleansing, a healing. This is situations that are that was unjust is going to be just. This month has 4 weeks. And in this 4 weeks, we are going to be looking at your energies. So we're calling in the angels for the Librans to see what is going to be coming in for you guys. In the first week, you have the energy of the Hierophant, which is the energy of the month. So some of you, if you have a legality, a situation with legal or with an organization that has to do with legal or conflicts in an organization, this is what is going to be happening. A balance, the Tower came in to bring in that healing energy and balance that is going to be coming in. Okay, as we look at the second week, let's see what is coming in the second week for you guys. You have the Three of Pentacles. Now this Three of Pentacles that is coming in has an effect. It's a working together. This Three of Pentacles is actually you working with others to make a success or to bring forth this healing. Okay, so I am basically loving this card deck, because it's coming out with just some wonderful energies. In the third week, what are we having in the third week? The third week, you have the Fool. The energy of the Fool is coming in the third week. So as we look at the energy of the Fool that is coming in the third week, we're seeing that after whatever the secret or whatever the information or whatever that was happening, because the first week, the general energy of the first week is basically the energy of your energy. So in the first week, you'll be receiving some messages. Okay, the third week, you're just going to decide to leave a situation behind and move on. The fourth week, you have an energy from the Knight of Pentacles. Now, the energy from the Knight of Pentacles could be some of you kids. Okay, so this could be some of your daughter or son that is a Taurus, Virgo, or a Capricorn. And you are going to decide to move away from this person. You're going to realize that the working, the energy of you working together with this person, because this person is between the ages of 25 and 45, it's not working. And you're going to decide to move away from it. For some of you, whatever situation that was happening, in your life, in conflicts with others and that sort of a thing, information is going to be coming out in the first week. Okay, a legal situation. The third week, you are going to be working together with the energy of you finding yourself. is the second week is going to be a week of you or trying to find yourself. Who are you? The third week, some of you are going to decide to leave an organization or a work situation or a boss or a company and start a new journey in a new company. The fourth week, some of you are going to be connecting or decided to move away from your son or daughter that is a Taurus, Virgo, or a Capricorn. Okay, let's see what is adjoining the first week to the second week. Temperance. So some of you are have to be finding inner inner strength. You are balancing out the positive and negative, and some of you will be having a sense of bringing balance to your inner world, bringing balance to your inner world, and that is after you receive information from an organization, and you're going to be deciding to bring balance to the situation and think, you know, whatever it is, I'm moving on. Okay, conflicts is going to come up between the second week and the third week. There is the sense of conflicts, and this is why you're going to decide to move on with your life. Okay, move away, a new start. And this conflicts that is coming in has to do with energy of working together, the Three of Pentacles. Okay, this is the conflicts that is coming in. It's a matter of working together with the Three of Pentacles. You're work trying to work together to bring this conflicts to a resolution. Okay, and the energy of the Devil comes up. So some of you are going to be dealing with people of lower energy, or people who are dealing in with a high ego base. Okay, and this is why you're deciding to leave this negative situation that has to do with someone who is a Taurus, Virgo, or a Capricorn. Okay, and it can be someone between the ages of 25 to 45. There's a lot of major arcana. Let's see what else is coming out for you, Liberance. The Four of Pentacles. You're trying to hold on onto what you have, and you're trying to build on what you have. So, it's as if information comes from an organization that you need to find inner strength to balance out that situation, and it has to do with you holding on to your financial situation and try to make better of it. Ace of Swords, this is good. So you're going to be victoriously coming out of this situation, whatever the energy of the Tower brings in this month of July for you, Liberals. You're going to be finding the inner strength to deal with the situation and move away from the situation. And you have the outcomes of you have to make a choice. What is the choice? There is a choice. This month is going to be a month of choices, a month of looking within to deal with whatever the situation is that is coming up. The energy of the Tower is not one of a positive energy. It's always cleansing. It's always an ending of a situation. Your month is a month of conflicts, and this is the energy that you have with people around you. The conflicts are going to be coming in for people who are working on a lower energy vibration, and you are going to be trying to resolve the conflicts because you're balancing out situation, but yet still you have people on this side with negative energies, and then you're holding on your financial stability, but and you're going to overcome this, but you have to make a decision. A decision has to be made. Whatever way you look at it, you basically have to make a decision about a situation in your life. You have to make a choice, okay? As we look at the energy of the organization, which is the energy of the month, you need to find balance with an organization or a group of people. You need to hold on to your financial stability and make a choice of what way you're going to be going. You are going to be victoriously overcoming the energy of the low energy that you're dealing with. Someone, it could be your son or daughter, who is a Taurus, Virgo, or a Capricorn. Okay, so this person is coming out as a son or daughter. If you are between the ages of 25 and 45, you have to deal with someone with a lower energy. You're going to be overcoming the situation, but you have to make a choice. Okay, you have to make a choice. So it's all about the energy of a tower is coming in. The energy of the tower is breaking down a conflict that has been around you, and you have to make a choice. Okay, so each and every month I do something differently, and this month I'm doing the mirror of the month readings to see the underlying, what exactly had transpired to give us the energy of this month. Okay, there is 6, 5, there's a lot of changes that is going to be happening. There's 3 times 5, a lot of changes that is going to be happening in this month for you guys. Changes is a month of changes. So let's see what has happened in the past. There was blockage in the past, in the future. The cloud is lifting for you Librans, and then love. Okay, so it was as if some of you were blocked from your twin flame or your soulmate. There was a block that was happening between you and your twin flame and your soulmate. The outcomes at the end of the month is that you will be connected. It was a karmatic cycle. Whatever that block was, it was a karmatic cycle, and it's coming to an end. In the future, you're going to be receiving an invitation. Okay, past, there was a situation with your health for some of you, and your, and for some of you with your finance. Now you're trying to resolve the situation with an organization, and the outcomes is secret or information is going to be coming out. Okay, so if we look at the past, there was the mountain, a block. It was a karmatic situation. It has to do with some of you, your health, and for some of you it has to do with your financial situation. In the middle of the month, you're going to have a situation where whatever that was blocking you is going to be ending. So this conflict is going to be coming to an end, a swift end. The conflicts that has been happening is coming to an end, a swift end. This conflicts is coming to a swift end. Okay, and what is transpiring is that you're holding on to your financial stability, and you're going to be overcoming a situation with an organization. Okay, whatever the situation was, it's going to come to an end. In the future, and the last week of the month, the energy of love, someone, your soulmate or twin flame, is going to be connecting with you. Some of you could be already in a relationship, and you're going to decide to end that relationship, or you are going to be receiving messages. Okay, so a new love is coming in. This is a soulmate relationship. You're going to be receiving message from someone who you have known from the past, who is going to come back in your life. Okay, and that is a soulmate or a twin flame. It's as if some energy were blocking you. Here is a contract. Some of you are going to be receiving a contract. Some of you are going to be receiving the hands in marriage, or asking for the hands in marriage. It is more a contract that was blocked. The blocked is going to come to an end, and it was a contract with an organization. That block is going to come to an end, and there is going to be a positive outcomes. So now I see why your month is looking like that, with so many transitions. Now we see what was the underlying situation for that month for you, Libras. So this is a successful situation because you're seeing all the negative energies that was, and the conflict wise, there are conflicts in this month. Okay, we are using the crystal deck and we have the Laplace. I love this energy because the energy of Lord Kumika is in this energy, is a past energy, and it's the Laplace. And I always use this energy. That's how I open up my spirituality, life-changing epiphany or experience. It's a time of big and blessing change for you, and God is supporting you each step of the way. Isn't this wonderful? So they're saying that it's going to be a life-changing epiphany and experience. It's a time of a big and a blessed change for you, and God is going to support you taking this change and step. So this is wonderful. This is a positive month, and it's really the energy of the tower. And this is a positive energy that's saying that this change is going to bring and the universal angels and guides are supporting you with this change. So I want to say to each and every person, thank you for being here. Thank you for being back. Thank you for the wonderful experience. Please like, share these videos, listen to your third quarter, listen to your sun, moon, horizon sign, and I'm wishing you a wonderful month. Sometimes you need to accept the changes that is coming in. Namaste.